allows people to get into one thing really heavily. I like more variety, so I was kind of an average kayaker, average mountain biker, average road cyclist, average rock climber, you name it. You know, a lot of different things, but I wasn't an expert in any of them. But I enjoyed the variety, and the reason that this was a little bit more background, my very first job out of college was with the Coleman Company, and part of what I did was work on their line of their pop-up campers, so I understood the history of that company and how they kind of did that, and I saw Sylvan Sport as an opportunity to basically create a modern version of the Coleman Company, because they basically, you know, they were, back in the day, they were arguably the best outdoor gear company in the United States, probably in the 60s and 70s. And through the 80s, they went through, you know, all the corporate raiding, and they were hastily taken over from the Coleman family when they tried to take it public, and it's a long story, but they, you know, classic, like, back in that era of financial hostile takeovers, Coleman Company lost the company. And that's basically when Coleman began its path to being a Walmart brand. And so I saw this opportunity to basically redo what they had done back in the 60s and 70s and 80s and create this this company. And the interesting distinction between, like, you have a Sycamore Cycles hat on, I think, you know. When I was at Liquid Logic, we sold tons of hats and t-shirts because that was your primary weapon, that was your piece of gear, that was your core instrument of your passion. But a camper isn't. A camper is a background piece of gear. So at Sylvan Sport, we don't sell and we don't expect to sell lots of Sylvan Sport t-shirts. It's because it's kind of like, you know, you name it, whatever your passionate hobby is, if it's cycling or, you know, kayaking, photography, name any. People are really loyal to those brands, but, you know, people don't really, you know, wear a t-shirt for, like, the brand of towel they use to clean their kayak off with. And it's kind of the same. It's a support product, you know. And the other strategic reason I like it is because when I thought about those trends, like windsurfing, you know, peaking and dropping, there's a whole portfolio of outdoor pursuits that we all kind of look at in the outdoor industry on a constant basis. I mean, everything from bird watching to bow hunting, you know, and there's in the outdoor industry, there's kind of two segments. There's the hook and bullet side or the cast and blast side, and there's the granola cruncher side, you know. I've always been on the non, I think it's the consumptive and non-consumptive technically. But across those huge spectrums of activities that people do in the outdoors, our product is this platform that can be slid underneath any one of them. And so we can, no pun intended, we can hitch our trailers to basically the emerging trends and sort of, you know, go into these different markets and promote. And it's, that makes it not only good business, but it speaks to what I said about me liking that variety. It doesn't pigeonhole me in any one spot.